I'm not robbing this house and I'm not a gardener either. This is my own house. We moved into a new house a few years ago. 2 days after we get settled in. It's a gorgeous day, so I'm out tending the garden. If you live in Louisiana, you'll realize that nice days are few and far in between. It's hot and muggy. About 30 minutes after I start, this woman walks beside the house. She compliments my garden and asks how much my services cost, so I told her, "Mom, I don't do services." About this time, my husband walks out and puts something into the car. So all's perfectly fine, right? No. This woman decides to call the police and tell them we are robbing the place. I don't know if her watching my husband caused that thinking as he was pulling stuff out of the house and into the vehicle or what. We were new neighbors, moved in like a few days prior, so you'd think she would have seen us moving. 3 cops show up a few minutes after she left. We didn't know she called the cops. They pull up while both of us are wondering what the hell happened. Maybe someone we knew died or our kid got arrested. Neither. They said we were called in as an active burglar. We had to prove it was ours. She didn't even talk to us about or mention robbery. Although I guess in the moment she just lost it. People are crazy here. A little kindness can make a huge difference. This will not be your typical "I don't work here, lady" story. Sorry for any mistakes. I'm on my phone. I was at Saks, picking up a repair, and the sales associate, who is also my friend and always helps me, was absent. My bad. I should have texted her I was coming, but since I was just picking up a repair, I didn't think about it. I went into the Louis Vuitton store inside Saks and was looking at the new collection. A nice SA approached me and I asked him about my repair. He went to get the bag, but the repair did not meet his standards and he told me he would make the paperwork to send the bag for repair again. While he went to the back, I was going around the store and looking at the bags. There was a couple purchasing, another SA helping him and 2 sales associates doing nothing. This is when the story starts. An elderly lady entered the store. She looked a little lost. I saw her approach the 2 SA who were doing nothing and heard them telling the lady in a rude tone, "What do you want?" Quote, she said she wanted to purchase her first LV bag. The sales associates asked her what model and one of them started showing her very pricey models. When the lady asked the price, one of the SA told her a very high number. And when the lady said she wanted something cheaper, they both laughed. I clearly heard one of them saying, "You're at the wrong store. Your kind goes to Walmart." For me, this was incredibly rude. I remembered the first time I went to that same store and was treated rashly. The lady, bless her heart, didn't say anything. Just left the counter and kept looking at the bags. I admired that since I would have left the store. I approached the lady with the biggest smile I could and told her if she wanted me to help her. She lighted up immediately. I told her I heard this was going to be her first LV bag and if she had any idea what she wanted. She was a little flushed but told me she had a price range which I totally supported. I started showing her all the LV iconic monogram bags. I spoke about the history of the Speedy. I showed her the timeless models. I basically did a tour around the store showing her everything I knew. After trying a couple of bags, she decided for a Speedy bandolier, the one with straps, and we were both super excited. I was extremely happy I could help her and she surprised me asking me to show her a wallet to match her new bag. Of course we found the perfect match and under her budget. She was so excited she hugged me and thanked me many times. Then the nice sales associate who was helping me came from the back and asked me who my friend was. I explained to him I was helping the lady pick up her new Louis Vuitton bag and that she may be perfect choice. I guess this is where it all clicked in. Lady. Excuse. You don't work here. Quote. Me. No. I was picking up a repair. Lady. But you help me and you know everything about this brand. Me. I wanted your first time in the store to be special. It's your first bag. We should all help each other. The lady thanked me again and told me I should totally work in LV. The nice sales associate who was helping me ring her purchased as we both started to tell you him. What happened street the beginning? He said he would talk to the manager. As I was leaving the store, while the lady was waiting for the bag to be wrapped up, the security guy at the door, who had seen everything but never stopped us while trying all the bags, said to me, "You rock." I jinxed myself at an Asian grocery. Hello Reddit. This is my first post, so I'm sorry if I get something wrong. A little background first. I'm half Asian, but most wouldn't know at first glance and just assume I'm 100% Asian. So my partner had taken me shopping at an Asian supermarket grocery here in the US, and I've always hated shopping as I grew up kinda poor and there aren't a lot of things in a grocery store that pops out at me. So I usually wander around aimlessly or play on my phone. Mostly both. As I wandered around, I saw a milk crate in one of the aisles. Thinking someone used it to sit down while stocking the lower shelves, I think to myself, hey, a free seat for my aching feet. So I sit down on it and play on my phone. After a minute, a realization came to mind. I'm wearing a plain black t-shirt and blue jeans. Just like most of the workers here. So someone might mistake me for an employee that is slacking off if I stay here. I take my time getting up. As I said, my feet were sore. And made my way to check on my partner. They told to go find some specific spice. So I went off in search of it. I'm reading the labels off the bottles trying to find the spice, and then this Indian, not Native American, came up to me and asked where the oyster sauce, I believe, was. I could not hold back my smile as I thinking this might happen. So I told where I thought it was but mentioned that I didn't work there. She smiled, embarrassed but thanked me and went to go find the sauce. After finding the spice, I went back to my partner and told him about the situation, and we had a laugh about it. Not a big deal like most of the stories here, but I thought it was funny enough to share. I'm so mad at myself right now. First, on mobile cereal, try to at least do the paragraphs properly. Truth be told, I've been lurking here for a few weeks and enjoying the stories. Especially.